Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nurfa Iza binti Ma'nor, and today me and my friend will present a task for automotive component manufacturing subject. Our project called Connecting Road.
For introduction, connecting rod is a connector between the piston and the crankshaft. It connects the piston pin to the crank pin. The connecting rod's small end is attached to the piston pin, while the large end is connected to the crank pin. The function of connecting rod is to transform the piston's linear motion into the crankshaft rotating motion. Connecting rods are used in a variety of automobile engines, and connecting rods also can utilize in various forms of vehicles, including cars, lorries, and bicycles. There are three objectives in this project. First, to develop and design an automotive part by using software with the accurate dimensions. Second, to manufacture an automotive part by using manufacturing technology in UTEM. Third, to implement the manufacturing principles in the fabrication of automotive parts. In design process, the software that has been used for product design is CATIA V5 2019. Figure shows the model of connecting rod in CATIA.
Hi Doctor. My part was explaining for manufacturing process. So manufacturing process was divided to three parts. First part was making patterns, then casting process, and lastly was CNC machining. So for making patterns, the first process of making patterns is sketch the drawing using CATIA. The dimension of the drawing is between the size of the hook and track of casting operators. CNC router machine was used to fabricate the wooden block. The coding was generated using CATIA version 5 2019. When run the CNC router machine, at the same time, we need to keep the wooden block clean from dust using vacuum. After the pattern appeared on the wooden block, we use bandsaw machine to chamfering the undesirable parts of the pattern. Next, after setup with making patterns, we proceed to the second process. It is was casting process. So the first step of casting process is melted the raw aluminium bar under 800 degrees Celsius temperature for 1 hour. Then we need to make the mold. The process of making mold is mix the green sand, bentonite clay, and water with the accurate ratio. After that, place the pattern with parting surface down on ground of the molding board in the drag part and cover the pattern with powder. Place the coat portion over the drag, attach both pattern, then mark the diameter of the sprue left and right side and repeat the same step of filling drag to coat. After both drag and coat are filled with pattern, powder and mold layer by layer, pop the sprue on the sand mold based on the mark sign. Then took off the sprue, then separate the coat and drag so that the patterns can be removed. Next, repair and clean the mold cavities. After that, make the hallway for molten metal to reach the mold cavities for both sides. After that, place the coat over the drag bag and then jab around 20 holes using a rod for air circulate. The molten metal is then poured into the mold by using long clamper. The molten metal was left overnight to ensure that the block is formed. After that, break the mold carefully and remove the casting. The last process are inspect the product and clean the material. So, we proceed to the last part of the manufacturing process, which is CNC machining. CNC machining was used for this project to get the accurate hole for the connecting rod. Before place the material in the CNC machine, the coding was generated manually based on the center of the diameter of the connecting rod. The coding was generated manually because half of the diameter holes was drilled by hand drill. The top holes was drilled about 40 mm and the bottom holes was 23 mm. The time taken to get both holes using CNC machining are about 3 hours. And then we proceed to the post-production process, which is grinding and sanding. The first process of grinding is the undesirable parts was rid off from the material, and then you use sandpaper from grit 60 to 200 to get the smooth surface for every angle of the material.
The next slide is Gantt chart. This is our project planning. We took 10 weeks to finish our project from week 4 until week 14. Next, we move to discussion. Based on the overall project, the part obtained from the all manufacturing process that selected are same as the design of product expected for this project. However, we experienced a multitude of challenges throughout the course of this project. In each project, problems are inescapable and we must confront them and find a solution sooner or late. During this project, there were some problems that occur. Luckily, we were able to effectively resolve the problem. One of the issue is that we use a grinding machine to grind the part and disrupted the actual thickness in order to get a flat and smooth surface. This occurred due to while designing the part in Katia, we should have enhanced the thickness of the part to avoid this from occur. After done the CNC rotor machining process, we can remove the unwanted wood block using the bandsaw machine safely. Then we can use the milling machine to get the actual thickness of the part. For this project, we have to repeat CNC rotor machining process to produce the new part. Furthermore, we choose incorrect manufacturing process, which is hand drilling. When hand drilling, we can acquire the correct diameter. This process also causing an uneven round surface. We had to decide to use the 5-axis CNC machining to overcome this problem. We altered the hole using a 5-axis CNC machining to achieve the correct diameter. However, in order to get a precise roundness, the hole's diameter had to be enlarged. So, the actual diameter of the big hole was 38 mm and enlarged to 40 mm, while the actual diameter of small hole was 22 mm and enlarged to 23 mm. Nonetheless, we were able to effectively resolve the problem that appeared throughout the project production. We have figured out what causing this problem and are calmly brainstorming solution. It is a standard practice for us to interrupt and analyze any problem that occur in order to keep the project timetable as tight as possible. As for conclusion, from this project, students can enhance the skill to model the automotive part using CATIA software. Then, students were exposed to hands-on skill by handling CNC machine, drilling machine, and casting process. This project helps to increase the value of cooperation and creative skills among group members for ensure the whole process for this project is going smoothly. Then, students are able to manufacture a connecting rod through the process of CNC machining, drilling, and casting. To sum up, all the objectives are achieved successfully. That's all from us. Thank you.